It means that today we are going to speak how the COVID-19 affected to all the immigration procedures and which are the new rules on regards to immigration in Spain because of the COVID-19 crisis. This would be mostly the conference about, and then we will also speak about the new regulations since 6th of July about Brexit and about how the UK citizens, they have to get their permits from 6th of July to the future. My name is Christian Balcells. I'm the CEO of Balcells Group. I'm the founder, and I will be very happy to explain you all these things today. We are a law firm located in Barcelona. We also work online for all the countries, so we have clients from all around Spain, from Canary Islands, Valencia, Madrid, Malaga, everywhere. And we have a YouTube channel where we post every week two videos, one video about immigration procedures, another video, which is the webinar of today, and the webinar that we do every week. Every day, every week, we touch a subject interesting. This week, we are going to speak about how COVID-19 affected to immigration procedure plus new regulations on Brexit. So we expect today it's going to be very profitable and very updated because these things are very new. So, well, just to let you know, we have a YouTube channel. You can subscribe. It's Balcells Group. There is a lot of information and on the videos. You also can subscribe to our website, which is balcellsgroup.com. We send newsletters every week, mostly with updated things for expats about legal, immigration, business, and taxes. We try to handle all the areas of the law, from legal to business to taxes and to immigration. So if you need any advice on any of these areas, you can contact us. And we created in 2013 a platform, which is called immigrationspain.es. It's a digital platform where we post things about immigration for expats, videos more focused on immigration and make easy the life of the immigrants or the expats in our country. I'm also the consul of Belarus in Catalonia, the general consul. So I'm very into the international atmosphere of the city of Barcelona, of Catalonia. We are in contact with consulates of more than 80 countries. And so our practice on immigration plus law, expats, we have also Catalan clients, Spanish. So it's a very interesting multicultural mix. In our office, we speak Russian, French, Spanish, English, and Chinese. So we cover mostly all the world in terms of languages. And we would be very happy to advise you. Now I'm going to start with the presentation. Well, here a little bit more of what I said, that we do immigration, accounting, business, legal, and real estate, and taxes. On regards to the COVID-19, there is basically three, four things to consider. The first thing is the extensions of the expired visas and residence permits. This was regulated in a ministerial order. This is the number of the order that regulates these modifications on the extensions. And what does these extensions mean? There is basically two scenarios. I come as a tourist to Spain, and my visa expired during my stay in Spain between 15th of December up to 21st of June of 2020. If your tourist visa expired during this period, then you have an automatic extension from 22nd of June. So you can be in our country until 22nd of September because there is an automatic extension of the visa expired. To whom applies this? For example, I'm a Russian, I have a visa, I came to Spain, and in February expired my visa, but I didn't go out of Spain. So because of this new law, you can be here until 22nd of September without having to do anything. Or I'm from the United States and my visa expired 20th of May. Because of this law, you can be here until 22nd of September. In general, if COVID-19 didn't happen, all the tourists, they have a 90 days visa over a period of 6 months. So every 90 days in Spain or in Schengen, they have to be 90 days out of Schengen. This would be the general rule of the visas, but there is some countries that the citizens, they need a specific visa with the date. So There is countries that the tourists, they can come even more limited than 90 days in the country, and then they have to be out for another 90 days. So this would be, in general, how applies to the tourists, which is, actually, we had a lot of people asking us this question because a lot of people, their tourist visa expired during the pandemic, and they were here irregular because they didn't, they could not go back to their countries, and that's why the government, to make them feel more comfortable and to have more peace in terms of immigration, they have approved this law that allows them to be until September to go to their country, 22nd of September. On regards to the residence permits and student visas, it applies the same rule. What does it mean? This, it has two scenarios. One scenario is, I have my student visa or my non-lucrative residence permit or any type of permit and expired during the pandemic. The pandemic was between 14th of March till 21st of June. So they say that if you were in the scenario that your residence permit or your student visa expired between 15th of December, 3 months before the pandemic, up to 21st of June, in this case, your residence permit and your student visa is automatically extended for 6 months. After these 6 months, so let's say 22nd of December, you will have another 3 months more, 90 days more, to renew the permit. So we are talking that you can be until March of next year, 20th of March, let's say, or 18th of March of next year, to be able to do this prolongation, renewal, extension of your permit, students and residence permit. So, for everybody. This would be the first scenario. I'm in Spain and my residence card expired. I have like an automatic extension of 6 months, and then they give me another 3 months to submit the renewal. This would be one scenario. Another scenario is, I was in my country when the residence permit expired and I could not go to Spain because of the pandemic. In this case, it is the same rule. You can enter Spain with your residence card expired. You don't need any visa. You don't need to go to the consulate to proceed a Schengen visa because your card is expired. No. If your card expired between 15th of December of 2019 up to 21st of June of 2020, then you have an additional 6 months plus 90 days, so until March of next year, you could enter with the card without a visa. This would be the second thing. Well, this is to confirm what I said, that if you were outside of the country when your residence permit expired, you don't need a visa to enter to the country to extend the permit, and you have until March of next year, 6 months plus 3 months, to do this extension. Well, as you know, another thing to mention about the crisis of COVID-19 is that between March and April of 2020, the immigration office was closed for fingerprints appointments. Then they started opening to do fingerprints and to pick the cards, but they modify all the procedure on regards to immigration to more online. But let's focus on the first thing. Now you can do the fingerprints and you can collect the residence card, but for both procedures, you need an appointment. Till now, it's becoming very difficult to get appointments, so we are waiting that in September, it will be more easy. Why it's becoming complicated? Because there is no appointments. The immigration office was collapsed long time, so in order to book the appointment, there is a lot of people who is applying for it, so there is no appointments at all. Our suggestion is to have patience. That's why the government, they extended all the permits and to be trying until you get it. We offer the service to get the appointments. The only thing that we cannot guarantee how soon we will get them. Another new thing is that to collect the card, you also need an appointment. Normally, before COVID-19, you need an appointment to do the fingerprints, but to collect the card, you just need to go to the immigration office. Now, you need an appointment for both. Why? Because they want to regulate the amount of people that goes to the immigration office in order to have less problems with the transmission of the virus. So as less people and the social distance bigger, better. The mask, etc., all what we know, because at the end it's impossible not to know it, because we see it everywhere. Another thing that it changed since COVID-19 is that before COVID-19, you could only do online the renewal of your residence card with the digital certificate, the modification of your residence permit to another permit, and the initial authorization for students. These three things, before COVID-19, you could do it online. To do it online, you need to hire a lawyer or to have a digital certificate and to submit all the documents online through the platform Mercurio of Immigration in Spain. And then the communication of requesting additional documents or the resolution even, it's given by the platform. It's very useful and it works pretty well. This was the only three options to do immigration online. But after COVID, or during COVID-19, they implemented to be able to do these new procedures online. Why? Again, because social distance, less people in the immigration office, less risk of contagious of the virus. Now you can do online as well with the digital certificate, and we can help you on this. You can do the arraigo social, arraigo familiar, and arraigo laboral. We can do also online the family reunification. Before, you need to book an appointment at the immigration office to bring some documents in order to bring your parents, to bring your husband, to bring your kids. Now the process is online. You can also do online the residence permit as a family member of a European citizen. So if you are a legal partnership with a European resident, if you are married with a European citizen, you can do all the process online. Before, and this is one of the permits that we do more in Spain or in Barcelona, you need to book an appointment in Calle Murcia 44, and on the day of the appointment, you need to go with your couple there and to submit the file. Now, this does not exist. We can do it online. So if we do a legal partnership at the notary, the same day we can even send the file to the immigration office, then it takes several months to be answered, but at least we avoid to book an appointment, to submit the documents, and then to wait for an answer. So online is better. Online is faster and is more practical in general. The initial application for residents for minors that they are born in Spain of expats parents, we can do it online. And this is very new, since 6th of July, we can do online all the British that they come to live to Spain. The ones that they are living here, they have a different procedure that we will explain at the end of the presentation. Another thing that we wanted to comment is that it has been approved a new format of the residency card. Before, in Spain, we had several colors. The students, it was blue. The European family members, it was orange. The investors, it was without color almost. It was four different types of TIEs, of tarjetas de identidad extranjero. Now, they unified all of them into a single one, but not only in Spain, in the whole European Union. So then it's easier to prevent the fraud and the falsification of these cards. And also it contains a chip with biographical data and images of the foreigners, so in the borders it's easy to identify if the person who uses the card is the person that owns the card. So this is just an anecdote, but just to let you know that now the process, the card, the format is different, it's new, it's better, more useful, and more easier for traveling. What happens with the UK? The UK, since 6th of July, the government of Spain, it regulated the procedure for them to get the residency permit of Spain. The UK citizens, we have three, four scenarios. One scenario would be the British who already have a European residency card and the family members of the British who already have a residency card. These persons, that they already residents of our country, they just need to book an appointment at the immigration office in Spain. And then on the day of the appointment, they need to bring their passport, a registration at the city hall, empadronamiento, and photos of themselves, and the card, of course. Then they exchange the European card for the European residency card for, let's say, a non-European UK residency card, which is valid for 5 years or for 10 years, depending if it's temporary or permanent. And this card allows them to live in the same conditions as the Spanish. What is the difference? When before Brexit, or the UK citizens, they had a permanent card. All the Europeans, they have a residency card that it does not expire. Now, the card has an expiration, And we also need to indicate the address, which in Barcelona, in province, for example, they didn't request the empadronamiento. Anyway, it's not too bad. I would say it's almost the same as the Europeans. The only thing, the length, but 5 years and then 10 is a very big length. So I think that it's for the procedure, and they don't need to book any, they don't need to submit any additional paper. They just need to go to the immigration office and to ask for the new format, the new card. So this would be for the British who are residents. This would apply also for the family members of the British who are residents. So if I'm from Russia, let's say, and I'm married with a British, first, the British needs to do all the immigration procedure, and then the family member of the British needs to book an appointment to bring the passport, the residency card, photos, and empadronamiento. And then the family member of the British will get the residency card as well, linked to the British. This would be a scenario one. People, British, who is living here, and their families. Second scenario would be the British that they are coming to live in Spain. The British who are coming to live in Spain, they need to do a different procedure. They need to request the residence permit online. So basically what they need is to bring a passport, a bank statement with euros with 7,000, or financial proof like work or company, medical insurance, which costs around 70, 80 euros per person, and the registration at the city hall, empadronamiento. With these four documents plus the passport, we submit through the immigration platform a request, and then they give us an approval. With this approval, we go to the police to do the same as the British who are already residents. And we will receive the same, a residency card for 5 years. This would be the second possibility, the second scenario. And the family members of the British, they can apply the same after the British becomes resident of Spain. The third scenario would be if I've been in Spain, like I'm British and I've been living more than 5 years as a resident, I can apply online for a permanent residency card. Once I get the approval, I can go to the police to get the new card valid for 10 years. This would be on regards to the UK citizens. Well, there is the limit until 31st of December, which I don't consider it a limit because we expect that they are going to prolong for the future. And we are sure that the British, they will have a good procedure or a friendly procedure to get the residency permit in future, that it will be close to what it is now or even the same. On regards to arraigo social and family reunification, the requirements are softer. The financial proofs of the company who hires the expat, or when you want to bring a kid, they are more friendly in order to facilitate, because of the economical circumstances, to facilitate both arraigo social and reunification. And in general, this would be everything about COVID-19 and Brexit. About the border, well, as you know, there is a list of countries that they can enter Spain as a tourist. All the residents, they can enter as well. All the family members of the residents of the European Union and Spanish as well, they can enter. And then the highly qualified workers, they can enter Spain. The professional sportsmen, they can enter Spain again as well. So this would be a little the policy. On Saturday, it's going to be a new order on regards to the borders, because tomorrow, 31st of July, it finishes what it was being approved by the government on regards to the borders. So we will see what will happen in future in the border in the next days, which can be an extension of the actual situation, perhaps a new one, perhaps more countries they can enter as a tourist. We'll see, because as you know, unfortunately, we are facing a situation of uncertainty constantly. So we don't know in which direction it can move, and it's totally even difficult to expect. This would be all about our presentation. Thank you very much. You can find us by email, in the website, by phone, and by WhatsApp. Our consultation fee is 60 euros, and then we deduct from any service that you contract us. We can do it in any of the languages. If you have any questions, we will be very happy to answer you.